Hello and welcome to Do It Yourself. You know, life is filled with challenges. You might want to say you can't do it, but you can. You can do it yourself.
Do it yourself.
I am Adam.
I'm Robert.
I'm Fernando.
This month we each made three cocktails, three drinks, inspired by the three of us. So it looks like, Robert, yours consists of a lot of frozen things.
Yep.
Why don't you start? Tell us your story, your process.
Okay, so I went through a lot of different ideas for this. I was actually originally going to make mead for you, Nando, which is a honey wine.
Uh-huh.
The mead kit didn't come in time. I canceled that order because I'm short on money. But I was going to do something similar to this. I was going to do it based off of your favorite drink from Seven Brew, which you have sitting on this table right now, which I remember correctly is blue raspberry, pomegranate, and sage with a green tea base.
Yeah.
That's what the mead was going to be. I couldn't get that done. I was super sad about that because I was stoked to do that for you.
All right, it's cool.
One of these days I'll make mead for us, which that's a whole process. It takes a lot of time. Mead, like I said, is a honey wine. You essentially, instead of fermenting from natural sugars of grapes or anything like that, you're fermenting with the natural sugars of honey. That's essentially what the yeast is going to feed off of.
Oh, you were going to make everything from scratch.
Uh-huh.
He was going to brew.
I bought brewer's yeast. I bought the whole kit. I was so excited to make that for you. I was telling Adam about it the entire time. I was like, Adam, I want to do this for Nando.
It came in late.
Didn't happen.
Gotcha.
So instead, I tried to go like, okay, what is one of those flavor notes that I can deal with really well to make you a non-alcoholic beverage, which I probably shouldn't have started with since the other two are frozen and Adam's over here is trying to die.
Right, that one looks like it's frozen. It looks like a smoothie or something.
Yeah, it does.
This is, I call it a blue raspberry fizz.
Okay.
Except, I know you like to be a little healthier. So instead of using soda water or anything like that, I used coconut milk. And coconut water.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So as you can tell, it's a little thicker here, but it is blue raspberry Starburst flavor packets mixed with, remember I asked Savvy and Savvy said that you like sour candy.
Yeah.
So I made my own, I made my own sweet and sour from scratch.
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Wait, what? You can do that?
Oh, yeah. It's so easy.
It's very easy. It's essentially just lime juice, lemon juice, and simple syrup.
Yeah. I'm a novice when it comes to drinks.
And then I mixed that with the blue raspberry Starburst, and then I just poured the coconut water in, and voila. I'll hand that to you.
You know, that's fair, Fernando, because, I mean, last month we did weightlifting, and that's what you're good at.
Yeah, yeah.
It's basically going to taste like candy.
This is something Robert and I already like,
mixology. Yeah, well, he's better than me at it.
Look at this. This is beautiful. Look at that. How is it?
Whoa, this is dangerous.
I haven't tasted that. It has no alcohol in it. But if it did have alcohol in it, I would recommend Malibu, and then that thing would be.
Oh, I could see that. Yeah, yeah.
Well, I want to taste it too.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
And then we got to do yours fast because it's trying to melt here.
Well, not before I taste it. Oh, yeah.
I also like the color too.
I'm surprised I didn't spill it.
I'm really big whenever I make drinks on color. And this one's so pretty.
Dude, it is. It's very beautiful.
I actually haven't. Yeah, I haven't tasted it.
Dude, I just want to sip on this.
It's very blue raspberry.
Dude, that is so good.
That's really good. It's good. I'm glad you enjoy it. Now, Adam's...
I'm not usually one for coconut flavor. And that still stands true.
Dude, I bet the calories are really low on this, too.
Mm-hmm. I like this everything just else about it.
It was supposed to be low calorie, not too sugary, but it uses natural sugars and stuff like that.
Dude, I'm so flattered.
Aww.
Yeah, I tried my best to make something that you would enjoy.
That's yours to sip on.
Now, Adam, I know you like to make drinks.
I do.
So I wanted to go a little risky here. I wanted to try something. I also remember you saying that one of your favorite desserts is a key lime pie.
Yeah.
This probably doesn't taste like a key lime pie. I call this a drunken key lime pie. I also know that you like more liquor forward. So I don't know if you can tell, but I floated a little bit of whiskey there. If you want to mix that in, you can. If you just want to take a sip and go in.
I'll try that. Yeah.
I didn't know you
and ice cream
float. Like
yeah,
another
it's, yeah, yeah. It takes some time, but you can do it. And then, of course, graham cracker. I was going to do a graham cracker crust all the way around.
Mm-hmm.
And originally, I was actually going to use egg white. But egg whites are finicky. don't really like them in drinks. If you don't mix, if you don't shake them right, they're horrible. They're awful. Mm. They, your drink tastes like egg.
Yeah.
If you don't shake them right.
I like the flavor of egg.
Wish you told me.
These are all surprise drinks.
What? Yeah. I legitimately changed my recipes like a day ago. Instead of using egg whites for yours, I decided to go with the best vanilla ice cream. Fight me. It is Blue Bell. I'm from Texas. Of course, it's the best.
I like Friars.
You should leave this room.
They have like a nice low-calorie vanilla. I can't taste the difference.
You know, it's,
whoa.
It's like a low carb.
Comments. We have a fellow Texan in the room, and they're just over there fuming. But yeah, I also wanted to do a little bit of zesting, but I forgot my zester.
That's all right. I can see your vision.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to drink it.
Go ahead. It's not going to taste like it. I know for a fact. But it's going to be interesting. And that's what matters, right?
When you're finished, pour some shots. Have you tried it yet?
Nope. I think it's too limey, probably.
Adam is in his, like...
Far too citrus, limey.
Expert drink, like, thought processor.
Like I said, I didn't really have time to fix this one, so this is all raw.
The raw uncut.
Which is kind of what I wanted. I was like, you know what?
Let's
make some content.
I would say I like this spirit-forward nature of it. I don't know how well the key lime is blending with the vanilla ice cream.
Mm-hmm.
I think, and like the dairy of it.
Yeah.
I do like the touch that the graham cracker offers. And yeah, I mean, this is mine to say.
No, I think you're right. It's very limey, and you don't really get the element of vanilla ice cream. Which, that's okay. I didn't really get time to experiment with this, but...
Yeah, it's really, you know, the citrus and dairy, when you're combining those, you have to be very careful.
You have to be extremely careful.
In baking, it's a little easier, but in drinks...
It's extremely difficult, and that's why I wanted to give this a shot. I'm glad someone caught on to my pun.
Just Lil Jon just comes out. Shots. Everybody.
The audience we have in the room is not happy with me, and I'm going to hear a word later.
And what's yours?
And mine is just something quick I whipped up. So this I call a Robert's Red Float. This
like Robert Redford?
Yeah, a little bit. I was
thinking Robert Redfly.
Robert's red flag.
Robert's red flags. These are all of my red flags in one cup. This is just Crown Royal vanilla, cream soda, maraschino cherry juice, and ice cream. And that's it.
Have you tasted it?
This one I have tasted.
Okay, then let us taste it.
I haven't tasted it with Crown vanilla, but I literally... So one of my favorite things to do is mix maraschino cherry juice with cream soda. It's supposed to be like a float, which means... drinking like a float.
So I don't really ever drink.
It's soda, good, right?
That is. I'm gonna so give this good. A try because it's my boy Robert.
It's just delicious and creamy.
Mm.
It was a favorite.
And now I have a milk mustache. Grab
a napkin. Whoa.
Kind of tastes like birthday cake.
Birthday cake.
A little bit birthday, like the flavor birthday cake.
That's like dangerously good. That's like, it's like melted like. Ice cream.
That's so good. And is there liquor in there?
Uh-huh.
What is it again? Oh, the
Crown Royal vanilla, which just hides really well in cream soda. Oh, yeah. That's something that I learned a long time ago whenever I was just making like two-part drinks. Cream soda, Crown Royal vanilla, you'll never go wrong because you'll never taste the alcohol. No matter how much Crown Royal vanilla and how much cream soda you put in there.
We're making a mess.
I do taste the alcohol.
You do?
Yeah, but that's probably because
like, you don't drink.
I don't like. I do drink socially, but I'm not really social. So
take a sip from the cup. See if that's a little different because the floating ice cream on top gives it a different flavor profile.
I know it's there.
You still taste it?
Like
I like your.
Glasses. I could just drink this. I could down this, and not be worried about the alcohol, but. I taste a hint of it there, but it's very smooth and it's very nice. Mm-hmm. Like, it's really good. It's like a milkshake, dude. It's like,
I know it's Robert. Like a, it's Robert's red float.
It's That's, like a yeah. melted milkshake. It's like so good.
I can only technically taste the alcohol. You know, you usually get like that zing. There's a word for the flavor alcohol brings, the bitiness mm-hmm. of it.
Yeah, yeah.
There's so little of that.
It's ever so slightly. I'm very impressed.
You know what it is? Like, I didn't mix it fast enough because I was trying to hurry
for this. You. Well, mm-hmm. you were still late, so.
The are we drinking alcohol or tea?
You guys may never hear from Adam again.
It's the other podcast.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. We have another podcast.
So real quick, our Check sponsor, the Sweet Tea Podcast.
Oh, yeah. The Sweet Tea Podcast.
Sweet Tea, not Sweetie.
No, it's Sweet Tea, not Sweetie.
Yeah.
Sweet.
That's the sponsor for this podcast. It's another podcast made by our friends. They talk about Southern culture and what it's like, I think, just to be a Southern girl.
Also, definitely. Nando, you made a mess out there, so I want to go to you next.
Okay, yeah. Nando's cool. next.
I will go.
What's your process?
To Robert first, and then I'll go to Adam, who is our expert. Mixologist. Would you say
we kind of decided appreciate it. To do this in like beginner, intermediate, master?
Okay. Yeah.
I mean, what I would say is I'm flattered to be called a mixologist. Thank you.
All right, so. I know that Robert said his favorite dessert is cheesecake.
Oh my god.
So I made you, and I didn't want to kill you guys. I don't want to send you to the hospital. So what I did was I went online, and I, as a novice, I looked up the ingredients to a cheesecake cocktail.
Oh my god.
So this has... I'll let you drink it first, and then I'll tell you what's inside.
Do you have a name for it?
Oh, I see it separating there.
It just goes by cheesecake cocktail online.
Oh, you're doing the whipped cream too? Oh, yes, Nando.
My friend.
Oh, Nando.
Nando, yeah. If you weren't single, I would marry you right now.
Whoa. All right. That's a lot of whipped cream.
All right.
Okay, buddy. Okay.
You know we're extra in this.
For our audio listeners, I beg you to look at the video right now. And see the beauty.
Oh dear God! All right. How am I supposed to sip this?
Oh, that's a good question.
Yeah, try it.
How am I supposed to sip this?
Take out the graham cracker, slurp up all that whipped cream, and then
it's all going down. Okay,
this is gonna get messy.
The podcast.
That was our friend Grant popping in. I think he sees all the alcohol stuff we're doing and is like, I want in on that.
It's all just whipped cream.
How is it?
It's good whipped cream.
I think, oh, man. Oh, dude. I probably put way too much whipped cream.
You do definitely get a burn of alcohol. Mm-hmm. I will say the crust on the outside, mm-hmm. dude, that tastes mm-hmm. like a graham cracker crust.
It's supposed to be blended, and I made it, like, before, like, coming here. Mm. So the alcohol might be a little stronger.
Yeah. The alcohol is definitely separated from whatever else was in there. Can you hand me a napkin,
please? I also learned that alcohol is really expensive, guys.
Oh, so yeah, it is.
I tried to get everything, like, in small bottles.
See, that's the other reason that... I put this off for a minute because I've been transferred. I just got a new job. Say congratulations to me. Yay. But I just got a new job. And so I'm kind of in that transition period. Mm-hmm. Didn't want to spend too much money on bottles. So got what I could from friends and family.
Yeah.
And tried to make your cocktails.
You can always ask.
I got like really small bottles at like Walmart, and I got like vodka, and then I mixed my own vanilla with it because like the vodka was really strong. So, and like it was kind of like a baked good. So I put like 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, and then I put like 2 ounces of vodka, lemon juice, out of the graham crackers.
I like limes.
So, you know, I haven't even tested myself.
If you added your own vanilla, this is technically different from the recipe you followed, which means it is your own drink and you should have a name for it.
Yeah. Huh. This is Robert's cheesy cake.
I like it.
That was awesome. I will say
he is quite cheesy.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got so little cake. Don't know if you can hear that from across the room.
I got a cream liquor for you.
For you?
It was like a. I'm trying to look it up. I'll have a picture of what everything. Bailey's original cream liquor.
Oh, it's Bailey's.
So,
but yeah. Like I said, honestly, the graham cracker around it.
Wait, so you haven't tasted these, right?
No.
Yeah, Adam. I think you're the only one who's tasted yours.
I tasted every single one.
I think you guys would like it. Did you guys like it?
I mean,
that's okay, guys.
I don't get it.
The presentation was 10 out of 10. Yeah,
presentation beautiful. If I got that at any sort of bar. I still have cream on my face, don't I?
I would say that flavor-wise, I wanted to get it down my throat as fast as possible. That doesn't mean it was bad.
That's fair.
That's what she said.
That was just my mouth instinct. Stop it, Riley. You're putting bad things in my mouth.
That's also what she said.
Stop it, Riley.
Continue.
Okay.
Did she lie? Sorry. So, if you guys thought that was a little much...
Guys, I'm starting
to be... Is this one mine? Yes, this one is yours. And this one, I know that you like Cajun food, mm-hmm. So I made you a Cajun margarita.
Oh,
okay.
No.
Okay,
okay. Okay, Nando.
Now, I will say, is that salt around the rim?
Yes.
Okay, okay.
It's a Himalayan salt with a little lemon juice.
I have one note right off the bat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's just... No, it's just red. Inspiration. It's like... Huh?
It's not red.
What do you mean?
Like, you know, like...
The drink?
Yeah.
No, I was going to say you could have used like Creole seasoning instead of salt to rim.
Tony Chatteries or something
that,
like that.
No, yeah. That could be fun in the future. It's okay.
Yeah.
That's a small presentation thing.
Gotcha.
Does not matter.
I mean, you sold us with the like with the name of the drink already. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you heard, but we were both like, oh.
Yeah.
So go ahead, man.
I mean, expound.
So I also ate the drink called for like tequila and like for me to cut the peppers.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't want to like kill you guys again or send you to the hospital, but I think that would be a funny thumbnail to be like, hey, I just
sent to the hospital.
Yeah, right, guys, we got sent to the hospital.
We continue the podcast in the hospital.
Yeah.
So right. Fernando messed up this drink.
I want to drink it.
So it's with ghost pepper tequila.
Oh, you
guys
know
that with us.
Yeah, you guys know I like ghost pepper tequila.
I didn't know that.
So
it's
for our listeners. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. I just got over some sort of stomach bug where I couldn't eat, and we're doing full alcohol and now ghost pepper tequila. So let's do this. I'm going to the hospital.
What makes it Cajun?
Just the mixes of chili, orange, a little like of that chili pepper.
Okay, yeah. Like, it has some spice to it. I like it.
So, I did put, like, an orange vodka.
Yeah, okay.
To the mix. So, I Googled that because, again, or maybe I should use the word unalive. I didn't want to unalive you guys, or I don't want to hurt you guys.
Yeah, it's all right. I understand what you're saying.
I didn't want to murk you guys. So,
no, we're good. I like that, yeah.
Also, I want to say... So, I'm a sucker for a bunch of salt on my rims.
I am not, but I can get over it.
There is so much salt here that I'm like, oh yes. I might just lick the salt.
So I looked up like, can you put vodka and tequila together? Like I Google searched.
It's a myth that you can't mix alcohols. You can mix anything you want, Fernando.
Yeah,
Google told me things, man, and it told me that like it's. Some things you can't mix.
No, man.
I'll send you to the hospital.
Stop it. You can mix anything.
It's like when you like Google, like, hey, I have a headache, and it tells you have some disease.
Yeah.
Literally, a Long Island is all your wells mixed.
Okay. Yeah. Exactly. Well, a Long Island is vodka, gin, rum, and tequila.
Yeah.
All mixed together.
I haven't even had this.
And I've experimented with what I call a short island. I see, just because it's the flip opposite, and I couldn't come up with a cleverer name, but it's dark rum and Yeho tequila, bourbon and brandy.
Ooh,
yeah.
Adam, you need to
make it. So it's all the dark liquors. I'll make it for you sometime. Yeah, good.
Do you taste the spice?
I taste the spice, yeah.
Oh, it's there.
It's subtle. Yeah.
I think
it's very subtle.
I think I should mix like some tomato or something.
Do you like it? I think
Clamato.
Like, that would be so good.
Like that would have been like
a little tomato juice.
Kind of like a mix between
some B8 or something.
A Bloody Mary and.
So again, if you adjusted the recipe on this, it's your own drink. What would you name this?
Oh, Adam's Redline.
I like it. What's your drink?
My drink? Oh, I just got a 7-brew drink.
He literally just got the 7-brew.
Sponsor us.
He just got the 7-brew.
This is Dragon's Blood. It's a mix of... Go ahead.
So that's not the one that you usually get.
Yeah, today I got something different.
You could have come prepared, Mando.
Yeah, man.
Savvy, why didn't you tell him to come prepared? You knew I was making a drink based off of his 7-brew.
Savvy is our producer, by the way.
Well, you didn't bring it, so it worked out. So I put blue raspberry, they have a mixed drink and it's blue raspberry and cherry mixed into like a green tea.
It's like
and
Powerade.
It goes down. Yeah. It goes down really smooth. It's really good.
Just exactly like a Powerade.
It tastes
actually
very much like that as well. Mm-hmm. Like, Robert's blue drink for you. Well, just cause it has blue raspberry in it. I'm drawing a loose thread between them. That's good. Yeah.
Mm.
Well,
I like mine more.
I guess it's my turn. Unless you have any final thoughts about how this whole experience was.
Oh, yeah, you're right. It was very cool as, like, a beginner. It's, like, I don't really know how to mix drinks, mm-hmm. but, like, it was just really cool, like, looking up instructions and, like, figuring out stuff and then, like, kind of putting my own little twist to it. I thought that was, like, awesome because, like, it's almost like cooking. Like, I like cooking and baking sometimes. So, like, being able to do that with a drink was definitely different. Yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about that.
I mean, yeah, no, that's honestly the most fun part about mm-hmm. this. That's kind of what drew me into this industry in the first place. Because, mm-hmm. like, I love making things, mm-hmm. and I love making people happy. So, it's kind of the best of both worlds. We all get happy with alcohol, unless, you know, you can't drink alcohol.
We're so sorry for you if that's the case. And if you're under 21, wait a bit, all right? Don't gotta jump the gun on it. You got this. My first alcoholic drink I did have before I was 21, but it was totally accidental. I was invited to a Christmas party, mm-hmm. and the punch was spiked. Sorry, I've had 1.5 drinks already. The punch was spiked with Fireball. And it was so good. And I drank and I was like, oh my gosh, this is so good. And they're like, oh no, that's spiked. How old are you? And I was like, oh no.
How old were you?
I was like 19.
Gotcha.
Yeah, yeah.
See, my first alcohol experience was much, much younger. But I'm from Texas. And in Texas, you are allowed to drink with a parent or guardian.
Yeah.
Even in restaurants.
I think that's the case throughout most of the U.S.
It's not the case in Arkansas, and it's not the case in other states. And they're starting to crack down. Texas is still one of those that you can go to, and you can drink within a guardian's presence.
What was your drink?
I had no idea.
My first drink was a Shiner Bock.
I'm sorry.
Because my dad loves Shiner Bock.
I'm just kidding. I'm throwing fake shade. I don't actually hate Shiner
Bock. And then my second drink, you know those little like pre-made daiquiris? Yeah. Daiquiri pouches that kind of look like Capri Suns? My mom told me they were called a Mommy Capri Sun.
Oh.
And she was like, you want to try one? I was like, yeah, sure. Absolutely. And I was like, this mm-hmm. is really good. And I drank more and more of it.
Yeah, yeah.
You
became drunk.
No, actually.
Oh, well then. It just tastes good. My second drink was called an Elton John. It was from the piano bar here mm-hmm. in town, here on Dixon Street in Fayetteville. Yeah, it was my 21st birthday. My buddy took me out on Dixon, and that was the first one we hit.
We have a lot of guests.
Yeah, someone just tried to come in. Why the heck would they do that? It's a podcast. Yeah.
Not going to drop any names.
What was your first drink, Fernando?
My first drink, I think it was like a little celebratory thing, so it was like I was underage. And it was like Patron, like tequila.
Admitting to crime.
And then I guess my first legal drink was like, I wanted something different because I already had Patron tequila, and that's kind of like the intro to like alcohol, or so I've been told.
My second drink, legal drink, was a tequila shot, and it was so good. Here, I'll be mixing this drink while you watch this video.
Adam, you filmed a video.
It explains my process. And yeah, I always film a video, bro. Oh, wait. So visual listeners, get ready.
Oh, wait, my first drink was sake.
Oh, like, sake.
Yeah, yeah.
Sake's a decent first drink.
Yeah, it was like in Arkansas.
I like this drink.
Sake.
Yeah.
It was warm. I had
that for my graduation.
I had cold bubbly sake, and I wasn't a fan of it than I thought it would be. Warm sake. Oh my gosh. That goes so good. So warm sake. Well. Yeah, yeah. Let's anyway, go. Your video.
My video. So yeah, I sent a text to these gentlemen asking them for their two favorite meals, two favorite desserts, and two favorite cocktails. That influenced my drink making. So this will give you a rundown of all.
I know that Robert loves gin. I know this. So probably going to be a gin-based drink. I'm going to grab some Beefeater, creme brulee, and cheesecake. Sounds like my man likes vanilla. Okay, and Negroni.
I do.
So Campari.
That's a nice color, dude.
Ooh.
Distinct.
Oh, no, Adam.
Cough syrup. The distinct cocktail.
My own drink. The Adam.
You're making the Adam?
I might tweak it a bit.
It tastes a little like a butter beer. Yeah. Just a little
bit.
Yeah.
I'm making Fernando's drink now.
Ooh. I have a pretty basic idea for this one. He said he likes tres leches cake. I do too. I'm going to make a tres leches latte. Literally, ooh, just lay my hand. Let me wash my hands real quick.
I love that Adam straight up put background music to this.
Yeah, dude, I love the background.
Oh, he put evaporated milk in yours. Oh, Nando, yours is going to be so good.
Oh, dude, this looks so good. Dude, I'm going to cry.
Oh, that looks really pretty.
You're welcome.
This is Fernando's drink. Based on the tres leches cake, I did design it myself. Obviously, your tres leches cake uses three kinds of milks, evaporated, condensed, and whole milk. So I am calling this the Valdez Leches Mocktail.
Oh, dude, that's sick. That's sick.
See, he's just good at this stuff.
Not yet.
My bad.
Just pour some soda water in so it foams up nice at the top.
Dude, yeah, no, I love the foam.
A little bit of.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, cinnamon.
Now are we going to light it on fire?
Drink it. The Valdez Leches Mocktail. Just... No alcohol in it. Very sweet, very terrible for your diet. Or not even a diet, you just like to eat healthy.
I gotta.
This is not
healthy. Oh, dude.
Easy to drink, right? No one's saying
it. I mean, like, whatever, like,
my God.
Diet I am in, like...
That sound clip is on the internet now.
Tres leches? Oh, my God.
About that leches.
Oh, I'm not passing this.
Because of your last name.
Dude, that is so good.
Yeah, I named each of them after our last names.
Dude, you could like sell
that. That legitimately tastes like a tres leches.
Oh, this is so good. I'm still drinking.
I call this one the more gin, so that you can say to the bartender, "Hey, can I have some more gin?" There you go.
I love that you made my name a pun.
I know.
I haven't really eaten much today, so this is not good.
No, it's very good, I promise.
We may not be walking out of here.
Adam, I didn't tell you how much I appreciated this and the name.
Of course, man.
I fucking love
it. Oh my God.
Hearts out to Adam.
I get why you think it's distinct. I love it. Yeah.
See, it tastes a lot like a Negroni.
It does taste a lot like a Negroni.
Here, go ahead, Fernando.
Yeah.
Nando, you're not going to like this.
See, that's the thing. It's very...
It's very distinct, as you said.
Yes. So I learned that you grab it from...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so yeah. Fernando, I based yours because you like a tres leches cake. I based Robert's because he likes a Negroni, which,
it's very gin heavy.
How are you feeling right now? Tell us, Fernando. Your face is telling everything.
It's very very bitter bite. It's good if you like bitter.
Yep.
Which is what a Negroni
is. Lots of Campari. Well, not a lot. But.
The after notes... Very nice. It's very smooth. It goes down like very good. It's just
you're being nice.
You have to be someone who likes bitter stuff to like. Yeah.
And that's Robert.
Mm. Yeah. I like bitter stuff and I like sweet stuff.
Yeah.
I'm a very bittersweet guy.
I like sour. Go ahead.
Normally I would double string it because you got a little bit of ice in there. But
Oh no, that's okay.
Right,
you know, it adds more character.
I didn't use a strainer.
Yeah, so that has a bit of vanilla vodka. Mm-hmm. So the reason it's not Negroni is because it is equal parts Campari, gin, and vanilla vodka. And that's it. No, that's not it. I added Angostura bitters as well.
Yeah, I can taste the Angostura.
Yeah, because you like old fashions.
Yeah, I love old fashions.
Yeah. Cool. And then there's mine. Mine is alcoholic. Oh, that's Fernando's.
See,
empty one. My bad.
The best way I can describe this is soap in a good way.
Soap in a good way. I describe that as cough syrup.
It's very Oreo. It's very floral. It's very herbal.
Like Dove Oreo.
No, like those Old homemade spice. Soaps.
Oh, okay, okay.
Like Dr. Squatch also sponsor us.
Here's mine. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, you're okay. Oh, you changed your recipe.
I changed my recipe. So it is white chocolate, Irish whiskey, and Irish black whiskey and brandy.
Mm.
And I'm topping it off here with Dr. Pepper.
I do like that you used the zero Dr. Pepper.
I call this Goffy Coffee.
See, I think it's because you had a can of actual Dr. Pepper.
It looks
in there.
Really good.
That's Goffy Coffee. Because it looks kind of like iced coffee.
Really does.
It is really good.
Except for the bubbles that are slowly trying to escape this glass.
No, it's like cold brew.
What like food would you pair that with?
With this?
Yeah, no. Like what? Like, no. Like a baked good.
That's perfectly to my taste. I enjoy it. What do you think? And also give it back to me because I want to drink it.
Oh, yeah. No, you go ahead. I actually think that would be better with regular Dr. Pepper or that.
I agree. I did not mean to
or
grab zero.
Dr. Pepper with cane sugar.
I messed up the whole thing because I grabbed zero sugar.
I think those glass bottles with cane sugar in them would work perfectly in that. But it's good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude.
Preferred the more butterbeer tasting one. I'm not going to lie to you, but that's for me.
Soda.
That's me. Yeah.
You can drink a butterbeer if you want. Get off my back.
I do love your guys'
get off his back.
Y'all.
I tried all mine. I tried.
I did. So every week I made a different cocktail. We did this in a month. I skipped the first week because I was, you know, procrastinating. And then second week I did Robert. Third week I did mine. Fourth week I did yours. Fernando.
Yeah, my approach was not that. I was very much like, okay, I have these ideas from what you guys said you enjoyed. Or what from Savvy said you enjoyed specifically, because I wanted to make you something that would be a little bit of a surprise.
It is.
I'm glad you like it. I can make you that as much as you want, and it's not bad. Yeah.
You have some relief.
Guys, this was fun.
This was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
We should do a part two.
A part two?
Part two.
Man. Y'all, I can't wait to film in a little bit now that we've had three drinks.
I know. I'm already feeling it.
I'll say, like, this was pretty awesome, though, because, like, for me...
All three of yours were non-alcoholic.
We did working... We did, like, working out, and that's, like, where I felt, like, very, like, advanced. And then we did this, and I'm like, oh, dude, I don't... and I had been thinking about it and then like I was just like I did try to put some heart into it. Mm-hmm. Sorry it didn't work out. But
I mean, I love mine.
Anytime you try to make something, there's going to be, I mean, look at the cocktail I made. Yeah. I tried something completely new and completely different with no real recipe for it.
Mm-hmm.
I was just like, I know that in key lime pies you use eggs.
Yeah.
So I was going to be like egg whites, kind of a lime flavor, vanilla to sweeten it because you do get a bit of vanilla notes in key lime pies.
Do you have any ideas on how to strengthen the cocktails that were made for you?
I really enjoy this one. I think actually a little bit of a sweeter note just to offset the bitterness. I love the bitterness, but I think I like a sweet than a bitter.
In the like video I showed you, I put a little simple in it.
Mm.
I did not do that for this.
You did not do it here. Yeah.
I did not.
But that's okay, because I still enjoy it. And if you love gin, this is a cocktail for you.
So if you were to change, you would add a little sweetness.
Yeah, just a little bit of sweetness. Other than that, I love it.
And your other one? Obviously, the one you made for yourself is perfect, because you made it. But
yeah.
Fernando's for you.
Well, this one's just like my childhood in a cup with alcohol. Turned adult.
Be honest, Robert.
Be honest, Robert.
I don't...
I can take it.
I don't really... You tried something that was very hard to do. Making a cocktail that tastes like a dessert is very difficult. Adam pulled off that mocktail perfectly. Mm-hmm. That's a very difficult thing to do.
I wonder if I put too much vodka.
Potentially, because there was a lot of bite.
Like, each serving was an ounce and a half, so that bottle has...
I also do think straining it would be a little better, because you wouldn't get the separation here, and it would be a nice smooth finish throughout the drink.
I think it settled, like, when I came here delivering it.
Right, right.
So, like, the drink kind of, like,
floated. Yeah,
because you brought them pre-made.
Yeah, which, I should have shook it up.
Which is why I didn't bring mine pre-made, because that one would have been, like... ice cream down here.
Yeah, we did have three levels of pre-made.
Lime right here.
Yeah, we had three levels of pre-made because Fernando made his at home and drove it here. Robert made his here at the station, and I made mine here at the table.
In front of the podcast. For you guys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anything that you would change about the drinks that were made for you?
Oh, man, maybe I would, like, probably do it in front of you guys. I would probably... I used a blender.
No, I'm
no, he means the drinks that we made for you.
Oh, for me? Dude, your drinks are so awesome. They're so fucking awesome. Like, I... Let me see.
I think I would add a little bit of sage to that to give it some herbalness.
Well,
I think that's something I would change for that drink.
If I knew that all of yours would be non-alcoholic, I would have added a ton of alcohol to mine.
I'd be curious to see if you put, like, Pop Rocks as a garnish.
What? Oh, my Nando, gosh!
That's such a good idea.
Yeah.
The man, he's a savant.
Guys, the three of us together can become one good bartender.
Oh, yeah.
One good mixologist. Yeah, our three brain cells combined.
Thinking about the Tres Leches now?
I think, like, maybe, like, a top layer on top of it. I don't know if you know the candy. It's called, like, cajeta.
No.
It's, like, this, like, Mexican, like...
Someone else in the room knows
about it. You know cajeta? Yeah. Do you want to try it?
Yeah.
It's so good.
Yeah, we'll let you try every single drink that we've had.
I would enjoy that, actually.
Okay.
I think if you put a little cajeta on top of it, it would make for, like, a sweet, like... earthy, like, kind of good taste.
Yeah, yeah. So a little bit of that in the Tres Leches?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The Valdez Leches.
It's almost like a caramel, but it's a different caramel.
That was the Cajun margarita. I like it. Enough.
It's because I have the sweet.
Yeah,
directly.
This will cleanse your palate.
I think next time we need something to, like, cleanse our palates as well.
Ta-da!
This is Chesney.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
She's been here the whole time.
She's been here the whole time.
Judging them.
She couldn't help it. She wanted the drinks.
We love Dropout.
Yeah, I've been super jealous this entire time.
Uh-huh. See, you like gin, so I think you like this.
But it has Campari, too. That's a distinct taste.
No, I do like that. I just like that as a...
Oh, okay. You had a face.
Well, you always have a face when you drink gin.
That is true.
Oh, I was trying to taste it too. It had a lot of different flavors. So, like, it definitely goes cherry.
That's right. You don't like cherries, no.
No, I'll try it.
No, it's the pig cherry flavor. Yeah.
I love artificial grape.
For mine, I would change the fact that I use zero Dr. Pepper instead of normal Dr. Pepper. This one, the margarita, I would maybe add just a little more sweetness.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Otherwise, I like the spice that comes with it.
You know what?
I think the tomatoes were also a really good idea.
Yeah.
The Cajun seasoning around it. Maybe combine Cajun seasoning with a little bit of salt to get that saltier
texture. I wonder if I can make it, like, a little, like, my own spin on it. Maybe, like if I put tajin, make it, like, a Mexican Cajun drink.
Yeah.
Oh, that might be fun.
Yeah. I mean, they make good, like, Tony's Creole seasoning is delicious.
Mm-hmm.
As far as yours, Robert, I don't know. I like the idea that you were going for.
It, like I said, it was a very difficult idea.
Well, it was an ambitious idea.
Yeah.
I think for this key lime drink, I would have maybe shot for entirely a key lime flavor profile. Maybe a bit. You can maybe have a little bit of vanilla in there, but Right now, it's kind of evenly split, fighting between two flavors.
And then the bourbon doesn't really help.
It is all gone, so you cannot try it. I'm sorry, Chesney.
Something you could do for this one is...
Yeah, the more gin.
Like, yeah, well... what I'm seeing is, like...
Yes.
I do like gin, but it does kind of get more bitter as you go down in can flavors. Can I taste it? This and one. I think maybe, like, some cloves or something would give it some more depth. Because it, as I said, it changes flavor profiles, but it just goes more bitter. And if you have the sweet before, it doesn't necessarily balance those flavors out. But some kind of clove or some spice might give it more depth and variety to the flavor.
I do like it more than a normal Negroni. Myself. I'm sorry, I don't mean to insult your culture, Robert. Anyway, thank you so much for joining us for the Dude It Yourself podcast.
Yeah, we need to go sober up. No, you go.
Oh, and remember, guys, dude it yourself. I will off key.
Promise. Normally, we nail that synchronicity.
We've just been drinking.
We've been drinking. Well, not Fernando, but yeah.